Hi, this is George from Digital High Road. In today's video, I want to do a simple study of how do you get a refund from Builderall. If you subscribe to Builderall at all, at any level, how would you go about getting a refund from Builderall? So at the end of this video, if you got anything from it and you liked it, please give us a large thumbs up. That helps us with our relationship with YouTube. They like that you like the video. Please leave comments down below as well, while you like what I said or where you disagree with me, or if you have something you'd like to add to the conversation. And also, if you're new to the channel and you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified every time I publish a new video that might help you with your internet marketing business. So let's move on into how to get a refund from Builderall. Okay, so in today's video, I want to show you how you would go about getting a refund from Builderall. I'm going to try to walk you through the whole process. Now, I'm new to Builderall. I've been a subscriber for about a week. I am not happy with the program, so I would want to request a refund at this point in time. So what I did first is I went to Google. And I put in how to get a refund from Builderall. I clicked the first page, the first ranking here, and I went to this page here. Now this person says, take this link to go to the home page, then scroll at the very bottom and click on the terms of use link if you want the shortcut. So I did that. Now I went to Builderall and I scrolled down. This is scrolled down as far as it goes. And this is my account here. And I'm looking for something that says it might give me an idea where to go to get access to getting a refund. So it tells me how to upgrade. It gives me all that information. It readily wants me to spend more money. But the page that goes this far, that won't go any farther. So I'm going to look here. Now that's to open a chat. That isn't it. There's nothing here. The page is blank. These do not have up here training, top training, affiliates. I'm not an affiliate. Notice this help support tickets. See, there's nothing here that mentions how to get a refund. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go to the next step. Since this didn't provide us, I'm going to look further in Google, and then I'm going to continue with this video after I find out what it is that we're looking for. So yes, I am confused at this moment, but let's move on. Okay, so what I'll do is look at the terms. This is the Builderall terms of use page. And you just come down through here, payment, suspension of services. That's not what we're talking about. Cancellation and refunds. Now it says here that the user is only allowed to request a refund for their subscription of the first 30 days. Exceeding the 30-day time frame will null your ability to request a refund. You'll only be able to request a cancellation of your subscription. The user is limited to one refund per account. This will not apply to double charges, whatever that means. And it gives you instances, special occasions, that they define in here. So that's what we're going to do is look at the terms of use page and the Builderall system, terms and conditions of use. Okay, to continue to get a refund from Builderall, I'm going to look into my account here. And subscription renewal date is March 11th. Today's the 9th of March. So what we're going to do is see if we can get a refund. I'm looking there, so I don't see how I can get a refund from here. So I'm going to have to do some digging around. Let's check this out. Email list, new subscribers. Now, okay. Okay. Okay, so what I've done is I've come in here to the Knowledgebase and I've put in how to stop. It's a frequently asked question. Here, we just go back. I put in cancel And then I pushed enter. And then it came up, frequently asked question, how do I stop a recurring? So financial frequently asked questions. Now it's going to show me how to do it here. So there's some good training there. My invoices. Cancel. Okay. Now it didn't show about a refund. So what I'm going to do is we're going to pause this. Okay. So I've followed the directions. I've come into the specific area. And then right here is the plan that I signed up for. It was $29.90. What I'm going to do is click on cancel. Once it cancels, you cannot be undone. You need to choose a new plan and be able to, whatever. Are you sure? And then I said, put in yes. Oh, it wants to type in cancel. So we put in cancel. Yeah, that's what it was. Okay. So do not put a capital C in. So it says cancel recurrency. And recurrent payment canceled up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a screenshot of this so that I have it in case I need it. So I have that. I'm just going to save that to my computer. I suspect that I might get an email to support this. So we're going to look into that. Okay, so I'm going to work on getting a refund. I'm going to open a chat. I've put down here, I'd like to refund them at $29.90. Okay. Now it says it's open 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So what we're going to do is I'll try this again tomorrow. Oh, there's Diana. Okay, so I've written to Diana. I said, hi, Diana. I just canceled a reoccurring payment, and I found Builderall to be a bit much for my needs. So now I'm waiting to see. Diana's typing. Okay, so Diana has asked, have you already requested a cancellation of your plan before? I wrote back, no, I haven't. I just canceled the subscription the last 10 minutes. Now I'm asking for a refund on my purchase of $29.90 I paid on February 11th, 2021. Thank you. Okay, so Diana has responded. I've created a ticket to check with our I've created a ticket to check with our team. We will reply as soon as possible. So please wait for our reply. They're basically saying they can't do anything via email and they'll show up a notification in my account. And then she just said the finance department will gladly evaluate my application for a refund. So that's it, folks. I'll continue this when I get a reply. Okay. So it's the next day. It's about 2 hours since I asked for the refund. I got two emails. Refund, they refunded my to my Visa card, $29.90. And there's a letter from support. Thanks for getting in touch with us. We really appreciate feedback. We just canceled your active plan as requested. And kindest regards. So that's pretty cool. That's what I wanted to show you was that's how long it took. It took about 22 and a half hours to get a response and get the money. It actually came in about an hour ago. Actually make that 21 hours. So that's pretty good. I wanted to share that before we get into the final part of the video. So that's it. That's the story and how you can cancel Builderall and how you get a refund from Builderall. Both things, I had no clue how to do it. I did research. I show it to you. I hope that helps you or anyone else that's watching this video. Make it easier for you to cancel your Builderall or get a refund if you wanted to get a refund, if you qualify for one. So if you liked the video, please give me a large thumbs up. Like the video. Please leave comments down below the description of the video as well. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you already haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also hit the bell icon, tap it a couple times so you get notified every time there's a new video published to our channel. And I also want to remind you down in the description, there's a link for some great free training that I use to build my business, training that you can access today. Don't put it off. Just click the link to the description down in the video, and you'll be getting some free training today. So thank you for watching the video, and so long.